Welcome to a quadratic function overview. In this video, we'll find all the major components of a given quadratic function, as well as graph the quadratic function. So we're given f of x equals negative 2x squared plus 5x plus 3. Let's start by determining the values of a, b, and c, where a is the leading coefficient, or the coefficient of x squared, b is the coefficient of x, and c is the constant term. So notice that a is equal to negative 2, b is equal to positive 5, and c is equal to positive 3. So the first question is, does the graph of the quadratic function, or the parabola, open up or down? We can determine this by determining the sine of a. If a is negative or less than 0, like we have, the parabola opens down. If a is positive or greater than 0, the parabola would open up. So again, we know a equals negative 2, which is less than 0, and therefore the parabola will open down. This also means the vertex will be a high point. Next, we're asked to find the equation of the axis of symmetry, which is given by x equals negative b divided by 2a. So we'll have negative, and then b is 5, divided by 2 times a, where a is negative 2. So this would be negative 5 divided by negative 4, which simplifies to positive 5/4, or in decimal form, this would be equal to 1.25. So the equation of the axis of symmetry would be x equals 5/4 in fraction form, or if we want, x equals 1.25. Now we want to find the coordinates of the vertex. The vertex is the only point that's on the parabola as well as on the axis of symmetry. And therefore, the x-coordinate of the vertex has to be negative b divided by 2a, or in our case, 5/4, or 1.25. And now to find the y-coordinate of the vertex, we'll have to evaluate the function at the given value of x. To do this, let's use the fraction form. So we want to find f of 5/4. So we'll substitute 5/4 for x. So we'll have negative 2, which I'm going to write as negative 2 over 1 times 5/4 squared, and then plus 5, or 5 over 1 times 5/4 plus 3, which I'll write as 3 over 1. 5/4 squared would be 25/16 times negative 2, that would be negative 50/16, plus this would be 25/4 plus 3 over 1. Now negative 50/16 does simplify to negative 25/8. Notice our common denominator here would be 8, so we're going to multiply the second fraction by 2 over 2, and the third fraction by 8 over 8. So this would give us a common denominator of 8, and the numerator would be negative 25 plus 50 plus 24, and this would be 49/8. So this would be the y-coordinate in fraction form, and 49 divided by 8 is equal to 6.125 as a decimal. Now our next question is, we want to find the x and y-intercepts of the function. So to find the x-intercepts, we'll set y, or f of x, equal to 0 and solve for x. And to find the y-intercept, we'll set x equal to 0 and solve for y. Let's start by finding the x-intercepts. So if we set f of x or y equal to 0, we want to solve the equation 0 equals negative 2x squared plus 5x plus 3. Let's see if we can factor this. So let's start by factoring out a negative, or if we want negative 1, so the leading coefficient would be positive. If we factor out negative 1, it's going to change the sign of each term, so we'll have positive 2x squared minus 5x minus 3, which I think will factor into two binomials, where the first terms must come from the factors of 2x squared, which would be 2x and x, The second positions must come from the factors of negative 3, so that the sum of the inner product and outer product is equal to negative 5x. So if we put a factor of negative 3 here and a factor of positive 1 here, we'd have negative 6x plus 1x, which does equal negative 5x. So this product equals 0 when 2x plus 1 equals 0, or x minus 3 equals 0. So to solve for x here, we would subtract 1 and divide by 2, x equals negative 1/2, or adding 3, x equals positive 3. These are the two x-intercepts of our function. One would be negative 1/2, 0, and the other would be 3, 0. And now let's go ahead and find the y-intercept by setting x equal to 0. We're finding f of 0. So if we substitute 0 for x, we would just have 0 plus 0 plus 3. So if f of 0 equals 3, the y-intercept is 3, which would be the point with coordinates 0, 3. Now let's take the information that we just found and graph the parabola. Let's start by sketching the axis of symmetry, which is a vertical line x equals 5/4 or 1.25, which would be here. The vertex is on this line with a y-coordinate of 6.125, which would be here, just above 6. Next, the x-intercepts are negative 1/2, 0, which would be here, and 3, 0, which would be here. Notice these two points are symmetrical across the axis. And then finally, the y-intercept is the point 0, 3, which would be this point here. But there must be a symmetrical point on the other side of the axis of symmetry, right here. And now we can make a nice graph of the parabola through these 5 points. Now that we have the graph of the parabola, let's find the domain and range, as well as determine the intervals for which the function is increasing and decreasing. Let's go and do this on the next slide. Notice how I have a nice computerized graph of the parabola here. Remember, the domain represents all the possible x values. Graphically, the x-axis moves from left to right, so we're also asking how far left and right does this graph go. Notice how it doesn't have any breaks, and while it is moving down very quickly, it's also moving left and right forever, and therefore the domain would be all real numbers. But using interval notation would be the interval from negative infinity to positive infinity. This will always be the domain for every quadratic function. And then the range will be the set of all possible y values. We'll notice that the y-axis moves up and down, so we're really trying to determine how this graph behaves moving up and down. We'll notice how it does go down forever, but it does not go up forever. The highest point would be here, which would be the y-coordinate of the vertex, which we know is 49/8 or 6.125. Which means the range would be down forever, meaning from negative infinity, up to a high value of 6.125 or 49/8. It includes this y value, so it's closed on 49/8. So we use a square bracket using interval notation. Of course, we could also say y is less than or equal to 49/8 to represent the same interval. Now the last question, we're asked to determine the intervals for which the function is increasing and decreasing. So again, looking at the graph, as we move from left to right along the graph, if we're moving uphill, the function is increasing. So it's increasing on this interval all the way to the vertex. And then notice to the right of the vertex, the function is going downhill, and therefore it's decreasing. We use x values to describe the intervals. Because again, the vertex here has an x-coordinate of 5/4 and a y-coordinate of 49/8, to the left of the vertex would be the interval from negative infinity to 5/4. It's open on 5/4. At 5/4, or the vertex, it's not increasing or decreasing. That would be a high point or a maximum. Then the function is decreasing on the interval from 5/4 to infinity, meaning to the right of the vertex. So again, the function is increasing to the left of the vertex because the graph is moving uphill, and then it's decreasing to the right of the vertex because the graph is going downhill. Okay, that's going to do it for this overview. I hope you found this helpful.